can be very busy for families these days, even hectic. And in all of this rush, families can sometimes take too much for granted. And one of the things that people increasingly take for granted is their food. For example, just like millions around Australia each morning, this table is filled with wholesome and nutritious food. But who knows or cares where this food comes from, who produced it, how its production affects communities, and how the food contributes to the nation as a whole. Many Australians are surprised to learn that much of their food comes from the Murray-Darling Basin. In fact, a great deal of the food that most of us have eaten in the past 24 hours comes from the basin, which is why the basin is referred to as the nation's food bowl. The Murray-Darling Basin has been in the news a lot in recent years. What with droughts, salinity, floods, water plans, wetlands, environmental flows, and so on. But not as much has been said about the role of the basin's farmers and irrigators who provide all of this food and fibre, sometimes under difficult circumstances. And it's not just food, it's nutritious, safe and clean food, and relatively inexpensive when it finally gets to the shops. For example, this bread is made from wheat and other cereals grown right across the Murray-Darling Basin. This milk comes from dairy cows, normally milked twice a day on farms in the southern parts of the basin and using state-of-the-art equipment. Fruit is grown all over the basin. It is then canned, bottled, frozen, dried, sold fresh, or made into drinks, jams, and marmalades. Most of Australia's oranges are grown in the basin. Eggs, bacon, honey, butter, even flowers are all produced in the basin. Serviettes and daily newspapers come from wood grown in timber plantations in the higher rainfall areas of the basin. As the family goes off to school, work, or leisure activities, they will probably take lunches and snacks, sandwiches, muesli bars, cakes and fruit. And tonight, the family will probably enjoy a meal of potatoes, meat, rice, vegetables, fruit and cream. Again, all grown in the basin. And who grows it all? Farm families. Farmers have been growing food and fibre in the basin for over 150 years. First on small holdings, but now on much larger farms. Some farms have been owned by the same families for several generations. Migration after the Second World War brought new people, crops, industries and cultures to the basin. And regardless of where they came from, many of these farm families have also contributed to establishing businesses, shops, schools, hospitals, churches and community groups in basin communities. Today, there are about 61,000 farms in the Murray-Darling Basin, and these farms grow a huge range of foodstuffs. In fact, nearly 100 different types of crops and livestock.
We grow many products, corn, maize, soybeans, canola, mung beans, fibre beans. There's a myriad of crops and food crops, as well as fibre, that feeds and clothes people around the world.
The Murray-Darling Basin is in a great temperate location. It's got good quality water. We've also got great soils that are able to grow good food with that water. And also we've got the sun.
Because of media stories, many people think that the basin is all under irrigation. In fact, only a small part of the basin is irrigated. The remaining farms are dryland or rangeland farms that rely on rainfall to produce crops and raise animals. But the basin's weather has always been variable, and it doesn't always rain when and where the farmers want it. So droughts and floods have become part of the life in the basin, and this means that crops fail from time to time.
Irrigation is incredibly important because in Australia we have a dry continent, broadly speaking. It's a way of producing food on an intensive basis, food and fibre. It's something that actually ironically complements the environment because you can shrink your production or expand your production depending on the volume of water that's available in any particular year. It produces a high quality food. We can value add it in our region, and we can then export it to generate foreign currency for our national economy.
It takes serious amounts of water to produce our food. One modest meal in 365 days in the year, you effectively used 555 litres of water for that very modest breakfast.
Where irrigation is used, water is stored in dams and delivered by rivers, channels and pipelines. There has also been huge investments in recent years by irrigators and governments that have made our irrigators amongst the most efficient water users in the world. All of this makes the Murray-Darling Basin a major producer of food and fibre, and not just for Australian families. Every year, our farmers export a significant amount of grain, meat, dairy, cotton, wine, wool, and horticultural products. Did you know that the basin produces enough rice to feed at least 20 million people every day of the year? And many more when you consider all of the other food products that are grown in the basin. When you add it all up, the basin's farmers and related industries generate about $15 billion every year for the Australian economy. This is nearly 40% of the nation's total agricultural production. And that's not bad for an area that covers only 14% of Australia. And as the world's population grows, this will be important for Australia's agriculture and food security well into the future. Most farms are run by farm families who enjoy leisure times, sport, travel and entertainment. They are often members of community groups and service clubs and play a big role in supporting the well-being of their communities. Farms are like other businesses that operate in towns, regional centres and cities, but there are some differences. Farmers often run their businesses in areas of small populations, large distances and variable weather.
It's really important that farmers are the first in line in terms of our environment, and we need to listen to what they have to say and understand how to help manage the environment for the long term for everybody.
Many farm families are involved in land care groups. They plant trees, remove weeds, control pest animals, protect native plants and animals, and improve rivers and wetlands. They also have a role in protecting Aboriginal cultural heritage.
Irrigation is a complex industry. It encompasses cultural and other issues such as that. Irrigators in this community are very, very strong on environmental stewardship and environmental management.
Well, looking after water quality and enhancing our environment goes hand in hand with food production. We as farmers have been doing that for a long time.
In other words, farming is increasingly about finding a balance between earning a living, looking after the environment, and being socially responsible. This is called natural resource management. It is not easy and usually requires help from the government. Farmers also use the latest technology to produce their crops and our food. They use mobile phones, computers, GPS systems, the internet, Twitter, apps, and Facebook.
You open up your laptop, if you're carrying one, or the computer in your office, and it will tell you the optimum time to put moisture back in that into that root profile.
Farms also generate employment in the Murray-Darling Basin. Producing food and fibre employs thousands of people, while thousands more are employed in regional centres and capital cities to process harvested crops and service agricultural industries.
Small towns that are in agricultural areas are there because they're servicing agriculture. And if agriculture's ticking and moving and performing, then that's what makes them tick and perform as well.
Ever since people have started farming in the Murray-Darling Basin, they've been affected by changes and they've had to adapt. Research shows that Australian farmers have a long history of taking up new and innovative technology and ideas, more than any other industry in our country.
The changes in agriculture and rural communities in the basin is certainly not going to slow down or stop. In fact, if anything, the rate of change in our communities is actually increasing.
farmers themselves are continually adapting and they're very inventive, they're very responsive. So, and every season is different. So we as farmers need to be continually changing, listening to what other people are doing, looking at other industries and trying to incorporate those sorts of things into our production systems as well.
94,
93, 92, there's a whole array of challenges. Climate is a key challenge. Commodity prices are a key challenge. Remaining competitive is a key challenge. Being able to pick up technology and be able to invest in new technology and research and development. So there's a challenge of attracting the next generation back to irrigated agriculture.
I strongly believe that young people are the future of the agricultural industry. They can bring so much to the agricultural business, technology, new ideas. I think it's a really great industry to get into. I have considered farming as a career. I love dairy farming. My friends and I are definitely optimistic about farming in this community. Farming isn't just someone sitting on a tractor in a paddock. There are so many different careers and opportunities in the farming industry, not just being a farmer.
So next time you enjoy a meal, give some thought to where all of this high quality, safe and nutritious food came from, who produced it and how it got to the shops. Much of it comes courtesy of our farmers and irrigators in the Murray-Darling Basin.
The world is growing in population, the world needs food, the world is becoming more wealthy and there will be more demand for better quality food.
These farmers would like you to know that they are highly efficient and contribute a great deal to local and national economies. Most importantly, they are not only trying to earn a living, but are also involved in protecting cultural heritage, improving land and water resources, improving the environment, and contributing to their communities. And that is something we should all appreciate and celebrate.